Afternoon, students. So last class we have discussed about the high pass RC circuit for the different inputs. So what are the different inputs? So sinusoidal waveform and step waveform, pulse waveform, square, ramp and exponential. So these waveforms applying to the high pass RC circuit, what is the response already have seen. Now another one, high pass RC circuit act as a differentiator. That means high pass RC circuit is called as a differentiator. When you are called and why you are calling as a differentiator? Similarly, low pass filter act as an integrator. So what is the reason? So here will be time constant of high pass RC circuit is very very small, then capacitor charges very slowly, very quickly. So RC circuit, time constant of RC circuit is very small, that means capacity is very small value. So capacity will be charging instantaneously or fastly, very quickly. So whatever input you are applying, same input will be transferred to the capacitor because capacitor will be fastly charging. So voltage drop across the resistor equal to zero. That means entire current will be decided by the capacitor. So whenever time constant is very small, that means RC is very small compared to time period of the input waveform. So in this condition, so what is the current value in terms of input voltage and capacitor value? So we know that voltage across the capacitor V equal to 1 by C integral of I of t dt. So then the derivative just manaku vachedi I of t equal to C into dvi of t by dt. Any formula, two formulas were there. So V of t or VC of t equal to entamma.
Mee voice break avutundi sir.
Okay, now you have to see. So entire input voltage taken by the capacitor whenever RC is very small compared to time period of the input waveform. So in that condition, so capacitor will be charging very fastly. That means whatever input you are applying, same input will be taken by the capacitor. So in that time, so current value calculation by using the capacitor is a major component. So in that condition, so we know that voltage across capacitor V naught of t or VC of t or VI of t equal to 1 by C integral of VI of t dt. So manaku kavalsina enti current equation. So VI of t equal to or VC of t equal to 1 by C integral of I of t dt. So integral of I of t dt means I want to be current means integration I want to cancel out. So integration will be cancelled out means will be requirement differentiation. So differentiating that equation, so VI of t equal to 1 by C integral of I of t dt. Then differentiation with respect to time domain to chase in tarvata manaku vache equation is I of t equal to C into dvi of t by dt. This the current equation whenever will be RC is very small compared to time period of the input waveform. Now output voltage across the resistor equal to, because the resistor and capacitor will be series connection, so same current is flowing through resistor also. Now voltage across the resistor, because high pass RC circuit means capacitor is in series between input and output voltage and resistor is parallel configuration, that means shunt connection. Across the resistor are taken output voltage. So V naught of t equal to I of t into R. But I of t value is C into dvi of t by dt. So from this equation, so output voltage is proportional to derivative of the input voltage. So output voltage is derivative of the input voltage dvi of t by dt. Here vi of t is nothing but input voltage. So according to this equation, you can say that high pass RC circuit act as a differentiator. So here, what is the conditional requirement? So time constant. Time constant means whatever the components you are using in the high pass RC circuit, resistor and capacitor value, that means product. So that product value is very small comparison to whatever the time period of the input sinusoidal or any periodic waveform or any time interval you are providing capital T. So in that condition, that circuit act as a differentiator. So why? Because here current will be passing through this circuit by using the capacity is very very small, or time constant circuit is very very small condition you are taken. So entire current will be generated by the capacitor circuit only. And next one, so what is the criteria for good differentiation? So previously low pass RC circuit act as a good integrator. So what is the equation you derived? So V naught of t equal to 1 by RC integral of Vi of t dt low pass RC circuit key. Output voltage equal to 1 by RC integral of Vi of t dt. In that condition, output voltage is integral of the input voltage. So that is the integrator. And similarly here, condition for low pass RC circuit is RC is far greater than T. That is a low pass condition, low pass RC circuit. But high pass RC circuit, RC is very, very small compared to time period. Now, put integrator, RC far greater than 15T are taken for low pass RC circuit. Similarly, for good differentiation in the high pass RC circuit, now what is the condition for RC values? So for this one, you have taken tan theta equal to 1 by omega RC. So how deleting this equation or this term tan theta equal to 1 by omega RC? So for this one, I'm going to the sinusoidal input applying to the high pass RC circuit. What is the gain formula? So sinusoidal input applying to the, see here, this is the high pass RC circuit, you're applying sinusoidal signal applying. So for this one, what is the gain formula I have written? See, the gain equal to output voltage by input voltage, output impedance by total impedance. Then after that, S equal to j omega substituting omega equal to 2 pi f. Now observe this equation. So gain equal to 1 by 1 minus j into 1 by omega RC. So from this equation, what is the theta? So theta is nothing but tan inverse of imaginary part by real part. What is the imaginary part here? 1 by omega RC. Omega is nothing but 2 pi f. And real part value is 1. So theta equal to minus sign. Here minus sign and here minus sign. Tan inverse of imaginary part. Imaginary part into minus omega by minus 1 by omega RC divided by 1. That means minus sign before you are written. Theta equal to minus tan inverse of 1 by omega RC or 2 pi f RC. Now this minus, I am considering only magnitude. Then this tan inverse brings the left hand side. Tan theta equal to what the answer will comes? 1 by 2 pi f RC. 2 pi f means omega. So tan theta equal to what the answer here? 1 by omega RC. So this equation I am taken here good differentiator. Now you have to see. So what is the criteria for good differentiation for this one? So sinusoidal input applying to the high pass RC circuit. Then how much phase angle leading by input waveform and output waveform? That is the theta. So here tan theta equal to 1 by omega RC. Now in this equation, exact differentiation means, suppose sin t derivative. So what is the sin t derivative? Cos t. So sin t and cos t, what is the difference between these two? Only phase angle difference 90 degrees. So that means correct differentiation in mathematics, sin t derivative is cos t means 90 degrees phase angle requirement. But in the practical case, high pass RC circuit, you are applying sine waveform. Output waveform is not exactly 90 degrees phase angle. That will be less than 90 degrees. So why it will be less than? So suppose good accuracy condition or ideal condition, so 90 degrees requirement, what we can do it? So that purpose you have taken here, tan theta equal to 1 by omega RC are written. So for this one, what is the tan 90? So tan 90, our angle is theta equal to 90 degrees will be required. Tan 90 equal to infinity. So infinity means in the denominator 1 by omega RC. Omega RC value has to 0. That means omega RC means here only 3 terms will be there. Omega, R and C. So once will be omega equal to 0 means that signal is nothing but frequency 0. So frequency 0 means that is a DC signal, not AC signal. So that's why omega is not equal to 0. So what are the remaining other conditions? Either resistor equal to 0 or C equal to 0. But once will be resistor or capacitor, any one of the 0, then the circuit is called as only single element, not two elements. that cannot be called as high pass RC circuit. So that's why two elements must and should has to present, resistor and capacitor. Now this omega RC value, how much you have taken here, example will be taken 0.01 will be taken. You have to see here example will be taken here is omega RC equal to 0.01 you have substituted. That means here what is the value, omega RC equal to 0.01. So omega RC value, I'm substituting 0.01. So 1 by 0.01 means what is that value? So 0.01 can be written as 1 by 100. So that 100 comes in the numerator. So tan theta equal to 100. So tan theta equal to 100 means what is the theta value? Around 89.4 degrees. But here our requirement is the theta approaches to 90 degrees. So what we can do it? Now omega RC I want to reduce further. That is the example omega RC I am taken is 0.001. Then what is the answer will comes here? 1000. 1 by omega RC value is 1 by 0.001. That value is 1000. So tan theta equal to 1000. Then this theta equal to around 89.6 or 89.7. That means very close to 90 degrees. Whenever omega RC value decreasing, omega RC value 0.001. Suppose I am taking 0.0001. Then this angle theta going to the almost equal to 90 degrees, 89.9 degrees likewise. That means this omega RC value, very small value required for the good differentiation condition. High pass R circuit act as a good differentiation condition is omega RC far less than 1. See that condition. Omega RC is far less than 1 condition required. So then only sine t waveform you are applying, output waveform is cos t waveform we are getting. But here taken is some example will be taken. Suppose input waveform Vm sin omega t will be taken input waveform. So output waveform is Vm into sin omega t plus phase angle. And this is nothing but some attenuation factor. This is a scaling factor. And the input signal mano RC high pass circuit and pass chesinappudu output amplitude, some angle amplitude will be reduced. Similarly, some phase angle will changes. That is the definition of linear wave shaping. So sinusoidal input applying to linear circuit, output also sinusoidal waveform shape. Only changes amplitude and phase angle. So that's why here Vm sin omega t are applying input to the high pass RC circuit. Output waveform is Vm as it is sin omega t, addition of some phase angle. This may be positive or negative. And next one, amplitude will be reducing. Some amplitude will be reduction here. R by square root of R square plus 1 by omega square C square. So this is the amplitude reduction and phase angle changes. This theta our requirement is 90 degrees will be requirement. So for this condition, omega RC is far less than 1 will be constrained. So for this one, is taken example will be taken. You have to see. Suppose omega RC equal to 0.1 this one. So 0.1 this could never 1 by 0.1. And then the 1 by 0.1 into 10. Tan theta equal to 10. So tan theta equal to 10. Theta equal to how much value? 84.3. So omega RC 0.1 this kunde manaku 84.3 degrees vachindi. Omega RC equal to 0.01 this kunde. So 1 by omega RC value 100, that theta equal to 89.4 degrees. Kabatti omega RC value taggista unte, then theta is approaches to 90 degrees, ideal condition. Kabatti omega RC value almost equal to 0, unte and far less than 1, then only, so high pass RC circuit called as differentiator, good differentiator. Adhe low pass aithe RC far greater than 15T, 15 into capital T. But in the high pass R circuit, good differentiator, omega RC far less than 1. This is the condition for good differentiator. So now I'm moving to the another topic, double differentiation. So differentiation means high pass R circuit. So capacitor is series and resistor is shunt connection. So double differentiation and the high pass RC circuit will run on it. So you have to observe this diagram. This is the first high pass R circuit diagram. This is another high pass R circuit diagram. So this time constant is R1C1, this time constant is R2C2. They are the two high pass R circuit, two differentiated circuits. But in between you are connecting is amplifier. In between you are connecting is some amplifier. So now these two high pass circuit connected as a cascade connection. Already I have studied in the EDC, electronic device and circuits, cascade and cascode. So common emitter configuration will be cascade will be there. Similarly, one of the CE and CB configuration, cascode, different combinations. Same configuration is cascade. So here also, same configurations, high pass circuit, here also high pass circuit, but different elements. That means R1, C1 time constant is different, R2, C2 time constant is different. Now, this here important one is, output impedance is small relative to R2, C2. That means this amplifier you are selecting, this output impedance will be always will be low. Generally, any of the amplifier circuit, input impedance is very high, output impedance is very low will be considered. Now to study already EDC. So any of the amplifier circuit, input impedance is very high. Similarly, output impedance or output resistance is equal to very low will be considered. Similarly here, compared to R2, C2, this output impedance of amplifier circuit is very small. Does not load the amplifier circuit. And next one here, what is the R1? So here will be R1 is this input impedance of the amplifier and high pass R circuit resistance. These two parallel combination you are assuming is R1. So actually here will be C1, here will be some resistance with the high pass R circuit, the tracer and amplifier input impedance. These two parallel combination resultant resistance you are assuming R1. Now time constants R1 C1, R2 C2. This is a very small relative to the period of the input waveform. So high pass RC circuit lo always will be considering RC is very very small compared to time period of the input waveform. As a low pass aithe RC far greater than T. These are the very very important one. So low pass means RC far greater than T, high pass means RC far less than T conditions. Now these R1 C1 and R2 C2 are far less than capital T. This capital T means period of the input waveform. In that condition, this circuit act as a second order differential equation until d square vi of t by dt square. Suppose vi of t in derivative with respect to time. D into vi of t by dt. This is the first order differentiation. That is second order derivative under d square vi of t by dt square. And input voltage two times differentiation. Similar here, input voltage second two times will be differentiation. In between will be amplifier will be there. So this circuit is called as rate of rise of amplifier. So why you call as rate of rise of amplifier? So for this one, you have to see the second one. So ramp voltage waveform you are applying as an input, then output waveform we're generating is pulse waveform. And important one, why you call as rate of rise means the initial slope of the output wave is initial slope of the input multiplied by gain of the amplifier. And then output slope, output waveform of this circuit equal to output waveform slope of this circuit equal to input waveform slope multiplied by gain. So that's why this is called as rate of rise amplifier. But this is not in syllabus, but in the end exam may be asking in the part A question. No bonus marks will be added. And next come to the another in the syllabus topic, attenuators. This is one of the important topic also. So what is meant by attenuator? So generally for the simple example, I can say that for electrical student, suppose Nagarjuna Sri Salem will be power generation circuits will be there. How much volt will be generated? 230 volts will be generated, 50 hertz sinusoidal signal, AC signal. Now coming to the Guntur or Vijayawada, around 300 kilometers far away, then voltage signal strength will be decreases. That means 200 volts you are receiving. So what about the 30 volts? So this 30 volt signal strength will be voltage value, voltage amplitude value will be decreases. Why it will be decreases? Because the signal will be transmitting long distance within the cables. What are the aluminum cables? So intra-atomic structure of the aluminum cable. So whatever the AC signal be, abstractal. So flow of electrons will be opposite this one, intra-atomic structure. So that means those are observing some voltage or some voltage drop will be available in the cable. Whatever the aluminum cable or copper cable, any cable one. Generally, you are using aluminum cable, you are using. So for this one, increasing purpose, what you can do it? You are using transformers. So step up transformers you are using. Then you will be manufacturing a 230 volts output you are getting. Generally, in a household application or industry, 230 volts AC supply you are using. Similarly, here also, attenuator is nothing but simple resistive network. So simple resistive network to reduce the amplitude of the input signal. So to reduce the amplitude of the input signal. Here one doubt will be there. Why your input signal amplitude will be reduced? Enduku input signal amplitude taggichali? So for this one, let us example. You already done in the EDC lab experiments. Let us example half wave rectifier or full wave rectifier. So what is the meaning of rectifier? So rectifier is nothing but converting AC voltage to DC voltage. Generally, pulsating DC are getting. So after pulsating DC, you want to perfect DC. That means ripples you have to elimination purpose. You are using with filters. So with filter means generally capacitor will be connected. Now this half wave rectifier by using or full wave rectifier with using filters will be generating DC voltage. Let us example, this DC voltage will be 9 volts. Let us example, I am using the transformer, step down transformer, 230 volts to either will be 909 or 9. Secondary side voltage value is 9 volts. That means 9 volts AC signal that will be converting to, let us example assuming 9 volts DC. But in the some of the ICs, integrated circuits, any TV or any remote or any electronic components, they are using integrated circuit IC. This integrated circuit is nothing but combination of different gates. You are studying the DLD, STLD, logic gates, AND gates, OR gate, NOT gates, likewise, or transistors. This IC is nothing but combination of either gates or transistors. More number of transistors or more number of gates will be inbuilt in single integrated chip. So now this circuit will be looking like a black color one in the top, and sides will be getting as pins will be there, small pins. So this pins will be supply voltage will be required 5 volts. I am explaining on example only. That IC will be operating in the 5 volts. But I will be transformer, half wave rectifier or full wave rectifier, output is generating 9 volts. What we can do it? 9 volts directly man apply it and kill. Mana calls in 5 volts. So this 4 volts you have to drop it out of 9 volts of the output of the secondary side of the transformer, half wave rectifier or full wave rectifier. So for this purpose, you are providing simple resistor. The resistor drop equal to, you have to maintain 4 volts, then output will be 5 volts will be constant. So likewise, some of the applications will be there. Sometimes will be voltage may be increase, or sometimes maybe will be decrease it. So some of the applications in attenuators, amplitude strength will be decreasing applications. How will be amplitude will be decreased? By using simple resistor network. That means attenuation nothing but simply reduce the amplitude of the input signal to a certain level. How much will be reducing? So for this one, I'm taking here voltage divider network. So voltage divider network means simple two resistors will be there. One is a series connection, second one is shunt connection. You have to see R1 is series connection. That means input end, this is a VI, this is a V0. In between series connection, you connect R1 resistor, one resistor. Next one, parallel connection. There is shunt connection R2. Across R2, I want to find out the output voltage. Now, what is the output voltage? So, simple resistor network, both will be series combination. R1 and R2 will be series, same current is flowing. Now, what is the output voltage? Or otherwise, voltage gain. So, voltage gain means output voltage by input voltage. Simply, output impedance by total impedance. Then, after that, output voltage equal to input voltage into output impedance by total impedance. Output impedance means across resistor R2. By total impedance means or input voltage. So R1 plus R2 into generally in terms of current lo meer rastapudu R2 into indulo current I of t flow ayyindi ankonde R2 into I of t rastaru output voltage. Adhe input voltage equal to V I of t equal to R1 into I of t plus R2 into I of t. So paina kinda I of t cancel ayyindi only resistance ratio comes or impedance ratio. So here will be output voltage equal to input voltage into R2 by R1 plus R2. Suppose I'm applying input is 10 volts. Now output 5 volts call. And what is the values? I have to choose it R1 and R2 values. Input is 10 volts, but output I want only 5 volts. And input loss angle. So then what is the combinations of R1 and R2 I have to choose? So R1 equal to R2 equal to, let us example, 1 kilo ohm. And in the R1, R2, two values, got a same values are taken. Then, what is the output voltage? You have to check it. So, VI equal to 10 volts. So, R1, R2 same. Kabatti ikkada R1 by 2R1. So, 1 by 2. 1 by 2 into VI. That means output voltage half of the input voltage. When R1 equal to R2 equal to some value, constant value. Both are equal condition. That means output voltage, how much voltage will be requirement depends on which value? R2 value and R1 values. So according choosing the resistor values, whatever the output value will be requirement. Suppose input voltage 10 volts and output 6 volts. అప్పుడు ఏం చేయాలి చెప్పండి, 6 వోల్ట్స్ కావాలి, ఐ వాంట్ ఇన్పుట్ ఇస్ 10 వోల్ట్స్. సో ఆర్ టూ నేను 6 తీసుకున్నాను, ఆర్ వన్ ఈక్వల్ టు 4, ఆర్ టూ ఈక్వల్ టు 6K. సో 6 కిలో ఓమ్స్ డివైడ్ బై 4 + 6 అంటే 10. సో దిస్ విల్ బికమ్స్ టు 6/10 అంటే 0.6, 0.6 ఇంటూ 10 అవుట్పుట్ ఐఎమ్ గెటింగ్ 6 వోల్ట్స్. సో అకార్డింగ్ చూజింగ్ ది రెసిస్టెంట్ వాల్యూస్ ఆర్ వన్ ఆర్ టూ వాల్యూస్ టు ప్రొడ్యూస్ ది అవుట్పుట్ వోల్టేజ్ వాల్యూ. బట్ హియర్ ఇంపార్టెంట్ వన్ ఇస్ VI of t, either be any signal, either be DC signal or AC signal, any frequency. But generally you are talking here is, for AC signal you are talking, discussing here, AC signal or step voltage. Now first I am assuming that AC signal, let us example, sinusoidal signal I am applying. Either 1 kilohertz sinusoidal signal, this will be generated by from function generator. Now 1 kilohertz sinusoidal signal applying, so output also same value, R2 by R1 plus R2 into VI of t. Similarly, 2 kilohertz signal also I am applying, same answer, R2 by R1 plus R2 into, that means independent of frequency, output voltage will be independent of frequency, and input lo mana frequency change chestuna kani, input amplitude fixed one, only I am changing frequency of the input signal, but output amplitude will be fixed one, that is R2 by R1 plus R2 into VI. That means this circuit is independent of frequency. But now, this is the slope here. What is the slope of this one? So V naught of t equal to scaling factor. What is the scaling factor of multiplying? R2 by R1 plus R2 into VI of t. This is independent of frequency. Now this attenuator circuit applying to some of the circuit, some of the amplifier circuit. Suppose any attenuator and breadboard are connected. Let us example. So two resistors I am connecting likewise. Input I am applying. From function generator, 1 kilohertz sinusoidal signal taken. Let us example, 10 volts input signal. Now output I want to observe it. Where you have to observe it? Output waveform across R2 by connecting the CRO probe. CRO observing the output waveform. Now CRO having some input capacitance. Careful listen. This attenuator output I want to observe the waveform in the CRO. But this breadboard and CRO is some far away. In between CRO probe we are using. This probe also having some capacitance. Similarly, CRO also having some input capacitance. Now, the capacitor will be present across the R2 shunt connection. How it will be there, you have to see. You see the first point. If the output of the attenuator is feeding to a stage of amplification, ante manaki enti attenuator output voltage across R2 daggara teeskunna waveform ni. You have to connecting to any of the amplifier circuit or you have to observing any of the CRO circuit. But that circuit having either amplifier circuit or CRO having some input capacitance. That capacitance is called as stray capacitance. That capacitance name I am assuming is symbol C2. So now this capacitance will be shunt connection to the across the resistor R2. Now, what is the output voltage formula? So now output voltage previously written R2 by R1 plus R2 into VI. So this is a independent of frequency because here no capacitors, either R1 or R2, no capacitor with their shunt connection. But in the this attenuator is connected to any other amplifier circuit or CRO probe. Then that capacitance will be present across the shunt connection of R2. Now, output voltage equation is not equal to R2 by R1 plus R2 into VI. Now, what is the equivalent for this one? Now, what is the output voltage formula here? Impedance. What is the output impedance here? R2 and C2 parallel combination. Previously, I have written only R2. Output impedance means I have written R2. Total impedance means R1 plus R2 we have written. But now, output voltage equal to input voltage VI of t into R2 parallel with C2 combination, that impedance divided by R1 plus R2 C2 combination impedance. Whenever it will be capacitor will be present, capacitor reactance equal to 1 by j omega C. So omega means 2 pi f. Now output voltage depends on frequency. Why? Because this capacitor C2 is present. Capacitor reactance is 1 by J omega C. Omega equal to 2 pi F. కాబట్టి ఎఫ్ మారిస్తే అంటే ఇన్పుట్ సిగ్నల్ యొక్క ఫ్రీక్వెన్సీ మారిస్తే అవుట్పుట్ వోల్టేజ్ కెపాసిటర్ రియాక్టెన్స్ వాల్యూ చేంజెస్, అవుట్పుట్ వోల్టేజ్ యాంప్లిట్యూడ్ ఆల్సో బి చేంజెస్. సో ప్రీవియస్లీ ఇన్పుట్ ఫ్రీక్వెన్సీ ఎంత మార్చినా కూడా అవుట్పుట్ వోల్టేజ్ డస్ నాట్ చేంజ్. ఇన్ ఆర్ టూ బై ఆర్ వన్ ప్లస్ ఆర్ టూ ఇంటూ విఐ, దట్ వాల్యూ ఈస్ ఫిక్స్డ్ వన్. మనం ఆర్ వన్ ఆర్ టూ ఫిక్స్ చేసాం, ఇన్పుట్ వోల్టేజ్ యాంప్లిట్యూడ్ కూడా ఫిక్స్ చేసాం, ఓన్లీ ఫ్రీక్వెన్సీ వేరియేషన్. కానీ అవుట్పుట్లో ఏమీ చేంజ్ రాల ఫస్ట్ డయాగ్రమ్లో అటెన్యూటర్లో. But now this attenuator circuit is connecting to some of the either will be CRO or amplifier circuit. That amplifier having capacitance, stray capacitance, that is a parallel to the R2. Because of this capacitor, output voltage is not independent of frequency. And in the moment, attenuation factor man ganto chinda R2 by R1 plus R2 into VI. So attenuation factor ante ante R2 by R1 plus R2. Now that equation is not valid. Now the another equation, that equation depends on frequency. And another one, what is this, this diagram, C diagram. Now these two are parallel using the Thevenin theorem. So Thevenin theorem means voltage source will be short circuit. So VI will be short circuited, then this R1 R2 are parallel combination. This resultant resistance I am assuming is R and capacitor C2 as is. And at that time, applying voltage, Thevenin voltage equal to alpha into VI, alpha into VI. So input voltage value will be multiplying with alpha value. Alpha is nothing but attenuation constant. And next one, important one. Now output voltage depending on capacitor or frequency. Now this effect, how to eliminate it? This capacitor effect, how to eliminate it? So for this one, you have to see the diagram, top diagram, D diagram. So now I am one more capacitor connected, C1, across the R1 resistor. So by connecting of C1 here, this C1 is nothing but variable capacitor. So by connecting this one, now this circuit will be consisting of how many elements? Four elements. These four elements form a bridge circuit. So to see likewise, this is the four elements will form as a bridge circuit. So for the bridge circuit, now how to be operating whenever you applying either with step voltage or sinusoidal voltage. Now this circuit will be balanced condition. This circuit will be balanced condition. That meaning is whatever the effect of C2 capacitance effect is nullified by C1 capacitor. So initial circuit marketing only R1 R2 two resistors. So this circuit simply amplitude strength will be reduction. అంటే ఇన్పుట్ సిగ్నల్ యొక్క యాంప్లిట్యూడ్ తగ్గించడం కోసమే యూజ్ చేసాం. కానీ ఎప్పుడైతే మనం ఈ సర్క్యూట్ యొక్క అవుట్పుట్ని తీసుకెళ్ళి ఎదురు యాంప్లిఫైర్ సర్క్యూట్కి కానీ లేదా సిఆర్ఓకి కానీ ఇస్తే ఎదురు సిఆర్ఓ లేదా యాంప్లిఫైర్ యొక్క ఇన్పుట్ కెపాసిటెన్స్ వచ్చి మనకి పారలల్ విత్ ఆర్ టూ రిజిస్టర్ వస్తుంది. సో అప్పుడు మనకి అవుట్పుట్ వోల్టేజ్ డిపెండింగ్ ఆన్ ఫ్రీక్వెన్సీ ఈక్వేషన్ వ్యాలిడ్ అవ్వదు. ఇది అటెన్యేషన్ ఫ్యాక్టర్ ఈక్వల్ ఆర్ టూ బై ఆర్ వన్ ప్లస్ ఆర్ టూ. సో ఈ వాల్యూ అనేది ఆర్ టూ బై ఆర్ వన్ ప్లస్ ఆర్ టూ వే రాదు అవుట్పుట్ వోల్టేజ్. That value will be depends on capacitor C2 also. And that capacitor reactance C2 means frequency also will be existing. For this one, this frequency effect has to eliminate purpose. You are using one more capacitor C1 across R1 resistor. Then this circuit will be formed as a bridge circuit. This bridge circuit will be balanced condition. Balanced condition means R1 C1 equal to R2 C2 condition. R1 C1 equal to R2 C2 condition. The current flowing through the XY branch, because XY branch, a branch of current is zero. That circuit will be balanced condition. And now here I have given some of the equations. So this is the output voltage at t equal to 0 plus. This is the output voltage at t equal to infinity. So allow chini rendu equations. This is the initial voltage, output voltage. This is the output voltage at t equal to infinity, that means fine. For negative values of time, for negative values of time, this magnitude of the step voltage is zero. Whenever t greater than zero, then step voltage magnitude equal to how much value? Plus V volts, constant value. Step volts, V volts, constant value. That is a step waveform. The step waveform changes will occur at t equal to 0. When t equal to 0 minus input voltage, step voltage value 0 unto the ఎప్పుడైతే టీ స్మాల్ టీ ఈక్వల్ జీరో ప్లస్ సమ్ పాజిటివ్ వాల్యూ ఆఫ్ టైమ్ ఇన్పుట్ వోల్టేజ్ వాల్యూ చేంజెస్ ఫ్రమ్ జీరో వోల్ట్స్ టు క్యాపిటల్ వి వోల్ట్స్ దట్ మీన్స్ సడన్ చేంజెస్ విల్ అకర్ అట్ టీ ఈక్వల్ టు జీరో దట్ ఈస్ అ స్టెప్ వోల్టేజ్ డెఫినేషన్ బట్ హియర్ వెన్ ఎవర్ యూ అప్లైయింగ్ స్టెప్ వోల్టేజ్ అట్ టీ ఈక్వల్ టు జీరో ప్లస్ వాట్ విల్ హ్యాపన్ ది వోల్టేజ్ అక్రాస్ ది కెపాసిటర్ సి వన్ అండ్ సి టూ ఆల్సో చేంజ్ అబ్రప్ట్లీ అంటే సడన్గా C1, C2లో ఉన్న ఛార్జ్ కూడా మారిపోతుంది లేదా వోల్టేజ్ అక్రాస్ ది కెపాసిటర్ ఆల్సో బి చేంజెస్ వై ఇట్ హ్యాపెన్ లైక్ వైజ్ ఇంతకుముందు క్లాస్లో నేను చెప్పాను కెపాసిటర్ ఇనీషియల్గా ఫాస్ట్గా ఛార్జ్ అవ్వటం ఫాస్ట్గా డిశ్చార్జ్ అవ్వటం ఉండదు ఇట్ విల్ టేక్ సర్టెన్ టైమ్ బట్ హియర్ ఐఎమ్ టేకింగ్ ఇస్ కెపాసిటర్ బి వెరీ లిటిల్ అమౌంట్ ఆఫ్ ఛార్జ్ ఆర్ వోల్టేజ్ బి జనరేటెడ్ ఆర్ ఛార్జింగ్ విల్ బి దేర్ వై ఇట్ విల్ హ్యాపెన్ బికాజ్ అట్ టీ ఈక్వల్ టు జీరో ది కెపాసిటర్ యాక్ట్ యాజ్ టీ ఈక్వల్ జీరో ప్లస్ కెపాసిటర్ యాక్ట్ యాజ్ షార్ట్ సర్క్యూట్ వర్చువల్లీ యాక్ట్ యాజ్ షార్ట్ సర్క్యూట్ వర్చువల్లీ అంటే మనం కెపాసిటర్ ఉన్నాక కానీ షార్ట్ సర్క్యూట్లాగా మనకు కనబడుతుంది ఆ సర్క్యూట్ ఆపరేటింగ్ సో ఐడియల్లీ హౌ మచ్ కరెంట్ ఈ కెపాసిటర్ షార్ట్ సర్క్యూట్ at t equal to 0 plus so current passing to the this circuit is very high that is infinite current will be passing within the small amount of time that is at t equal to 0 minus to t equal to 0 plus the capacitor will be charging how much it will be charging will be there q equal to integral of 0 t small t equal to 0 minus to 0 plus I of t dt that is a how much will be charged whenever a sudden changes will occur at t equal to 0 ante step voltage mana t equal to 0 daggara sudden change aitundi aa sudden change ainappudu capacitor lo enta current pass aitundi I of t current is flowing because of I of t current is flowing through the capacitors that capacitor will be some charge will be storage will be there that charge will be q equal to how much will be charge q equal to integral of 0 minus to 0 plus this is small t I of t dt and next one initial output voltage determined by the capacitors ante initial ga manaki resistors kaakunda capacitor will be dominant one so now this across the capacitor gives the output initial output andukane manaki ikkada equation chudandi em isthunnam chudandi v naught of 0 plus ante initial ga manaki output voltage depends on which values capacitor values not resistors and next one same current flowing through the capacitors C1 and C2 because both are in series connection so initially at t equal to 0 plus same current is flowing through this one now charge accumulated in the capacitor already I written what is the charge accumulated in the capacitor of small t equal to 0 minus to t equal to 0 plus I of t dt now what is the voltage across the capacitor C1 సో మనకు ఫార్ములా తెలుసు వి ఈక్వల్ టు క్యూ బై సి ఆర్ క్యూ ఈక్వల్ టు సివి సో అకార్డింగ్ దిస్ ఈక్వేషన్ అకార్డింగ్ టు దిస్ ఈక్వేషన్ వోల్టేజ్ అక్రాస్ ఇనీషియల్ వోల్టేజ్ అక్రాస్ కెపాసిటర్ సి1 ఈక్వల్ టు యూఆర్ రెజ్యూమింగ్ V1 దట్ V1 ఈక్వల్ టు ఛార్జ్ బై కెపాసిటర్స్ వాల్యూ క్యూ బై సి దట్ మీన్స్ V1 ఈక్వల్ టు క్యూ బై సి1 దిస్ ఇస్ ఫర్ వోల్టేజ్ అక్యుములేటెడ్ ఇన్ ది ఫస్ట్ కెపాసిటర్ సి1 but current will be same in the C1 and C2 at t equal to 0 plus ante initial ga current will be flowing through the circuit C1 and C2 will be same current value assuming V2 that value equal to Q by C2 now output voltage taken across the capacitor C2 that's why voltage across the capacitor C2 equal to output voltage initially at t equal to 0 plus that equal to Q by C2 that is a Q by Q by C2. Now, what is input voltage? So, input voltage nothing but drop across the capacitor C1 plus drop across capacitor C2 at initial one. Forget about resistors. Initial one, I'm considering capacitors only. Now, voltage drop across the capacitor C1 is V1 and voltage drop across the capacitor C2 equal to V2. Now, input voltage equal to V1
సార్ మీ వాయిస్ వినిపించట్లేదు.
So here I have to taken output voltage equal to input voltage V, step voltage D equal to 0 plus into C1 by C1 plus C2. And next one, at final output voltage value determined by resistors R1 and R2. So that value equal to V0 of infinity equal to input voltage into R2 by R1 plus R2. So here time constant is nothing but simply RC, condition equal to R1 C1 equal to R2 C2 condition, circuit is perfectly compensated. That means output voltage value equal to R2 by R1 plus R2 into VI. That is a perfect compensation. R1 C1 equal to R2 C2 condition low. Manu input A frequency can apply as nakani output waveform. That means output voltage equation equal to R2 by R1 plus into VI. R2 by R1 plus R2 is called as attenuation constant alpha. That value is. So here, just screen share all is that?
Yes, sir.
My program button the PPT?
Yes, sir. My program
button the.
Yes, sir.
So, okay, circuit is perfect compensation means R1 C1 equal to R2 C2 condition. Output voltage equal to R2 by R1 plus R2 into VI. So, whatever value of VI, magnitude is fixed one, whatever the frequency of input signal, but output voltage value will be same. And input low frequency marginal kani, output waveform amplitude will be same. And a 1 kilohertz signal can the multiply factor R2 by R1 plus R2 rasamo, 10 kilohertz signal koda. R2 by R1 plus R2 into VI. That equation will be same in the perfect compensation condition. Suppose C1 is large condition. Suppose mano R1 C1 equal to R2 C2 condition. Suppose I have taken C1 is very large value because variable capacitance I have taken large value. Then initial voltage V0 of 0 plus is large value. Why it will be V0 of 0 plus value is large value? V0 of 0 plus value is nothing but input voltage into C1 by C1 plus C2. And the C1 value very large value compared to C2. Appudu manaki initial voltage value ekku untadi compared to final value. At t equal to infinity value kante ekku untadi. This is a overcompensation antaru. And the C1 value undadanikante ekku undi. And next one, R1 C1, R1 C1 equal to R2 C2 condition kaakunda C1 value small value aithe. So C1 less than R2 C2 by R1 condition. So appudu maniki initial output voltage value is very low compared to t equal to infinity. So this is called as under compensation. So meeku deentlo control system lo kuda perfect compensation lead lag compensation this will comes again. So this is a attenuators briefly. So this topic somewhat will be complex one. Simple one is first I am going to the simple resistor network. Two resistors.
Time out sir.
Just 1 minute amma dinu saramsam mottham cheppi main point cheppi odilestanu. So here will be simple attenuator circuit is nothing but simple resistor network. Enduku chestam amplitude strength ni taggichadam kosam. But here this amplifier circuit, this attenuator this attenuator circuit is connecting to either CRO or amplifier circuit. Then amplifier circuit or CRO probe having some capacitance C2. Because of this capacitance, now output voltage is depending on frequency. So this frequency effect has to nullify it. You are connecting one more capacitor C1 across R1 resistor. So bridge will balance condition R1 C1 equal to R2 C2 condition. Now output voltage is independent of frequency. That means output voltage equation equal to input voltage into R2 by R1 plus R2. This is the perfect compensation. Remaining two conditions, one is over compensation, second one is under compensation based on the value of C1 compared with C2. So next class we will see remaining one. Please wait, I will take attendance.